Hello students, welcome back to maths class. In this video we will see from question number 8 to question number 11 solutions of class 8 of exercise 13.2. So that the question number 8 is, a factory requires 42 machines to produce a given number of articles in 63 days. So whatever the work is there by the 42 machine, that work can finish in 63 days. How many machine would be required the same number of articles in 54 days? So question is, how many machine is required if the same work is there but that same work is completed in 54 days? It means that we want our work as completed so much fast. Here 63 days are going on and here we want the work is completed in 54 days. It means that when we compare with the table, machine days. First case, when machine is 42, that 42 machine can complete their work in 63 days. Its second case is, number of days is 54. We want that the number of machine. You can simply see we want the number of days as increase. Our work will finish in the minimum time. So when our work will finish in minimum time? When we increase the number of machine. So one value is increasing, one value is decreasing. It means inverse proportion is there. And inverse proportion say that x into y will be constant. So, machine is x and days is y. In front of x, x1 and x2, and in front of y is y1 and y2. Inverse proportion is here. That's why we taken x1 into y1 equal x2 into y2. X1 is 42, y1 is 63. X2 as it is, on the place of y2, 54 will be here. Here 54 is in the multiplication, so it will goes opposite side. And from the table of 9, okay, 54 will go 6 time and 63 will go 7 time. Now 42 as it is, 7 as it is, 6 as it is. From the table of 6, 42 will reduce 7 time, so that we have 7 into 7, and 7 into 7 is 49. So x2 value is 49, and x2 is the required machine when the work is completed in 54 days. So number of machine which is required is 49. Question number 9 is, a car takes 2 hours to reach a destination by traveling at the speed of 60 km per hour. It means one destination is there. If car is traveling at the speed of 60 km per hour, this 60 km per hour is continuously going on. So this 60 km per hour is the speed on that time the journey is completed in 2 hours. How long will it take when the car travels at the speed of 80 km per hour? You can simply see in the next case we increase the speed. We increase the speed. It means we reach our destination in less than 2 hours. Okay. This is definitely because we increased our speed. That's why in less than 2 hours we can easily reach our destination. So that time in hour and speed is kilometer in hour. So when we increase the speed, on that time the time taken for the journey will decrease. One value is increasing and one value is decreasing. It means inverse proportion is there. So x and y, in front of x we have x1 and x2, and in front of y we have y1 and y2. Inverse proportion is here. It means we can easily compare x1 into y1 with respect to x2 into y2. X1 is 2, y1 is 60. x2 as it is, y2 is 80. This multiplicative 80 will go opposite side in the division. So that the from the table of 10, 80 will go 8 times. This 60 will go 6 times. From the table of 2, 2 1 is 2 and 2 4s are 8. We have 6 1 is 6 and 4 as it is. Now we want to simply divide 6 by 4. When we divide 4 1 is 4, 1 time is here, 6 minus 4 is 2. For solving this 2, we want to put 1 0 here. And because of this 1 0, decimal will be here. 4 5s are 20, so 5 will be here. So x2 value is 1.5 r. It means when the speed is 80 km per hour, on that time the journey will complete in 1.5 r. Question number 10 is, 2 persons could fit new window in a house in 3 days. It means number of persons who are fixing the window is 2, and in 3 days they can fix the window. This is the main point of the question. Its first point is, one of the person feel ill before the work is started. It means before started the person, one person is going to ill. It means that person will not able to do any work. So how long would the job take now? It means out of these two person, one is feeling ill. It means the whole work is completed by this only one person. So that according to the given condition, when person is two, on that time the work is completed in 3 days. Now according to the new condition, one person is ill. Okay, so only one person is working. We want to take in how many days the work will be completed. You can simply see our manpower, the person who are working, is decreased. It means whole work is completed by this only one person. It means this one person will take extra days. It means this out of three, our number of days will increase when only one person will work. So inverse proportion is there. So x into y will be constant in inverse proportion. Person is x and days is y. In front of x, we have x1 and x2. And in front of y, we have y1 and y2. Simply, from the previous method, we will solve. X1 into y1 will compare with x2 into y2. X1 is 2. Y1 is 3. X2 is 1 and Y2 is as it is. This multiplicative 1 will go opposite side, and 2 3s are 6 days for the Y2. It means one person requires 6 days to finish job. Okay, it means this, when the one person will work for the whole work, on that time, that one person will require 6 days for completion the work. Its second part, how many person would be needed to fit the windows in 1 day? Okay, so same condition that was given in the main point, when 2 person are working, that 2 person will finish the work in 3 days. But the new case is, how many person is required? Okay, this place is unknown, but when the work is finishes in 1 day, it means our days increase. So when our work is finishes so fast, here out of three we are completing our work in 1 day. We are completing our work in 1 day. It means work is completed in so much fast way. So when it will, how it can be occur? It can be occur when we increase the number of person for the working. In that case only, when we increase the number of person, on that time the number of days will be less. So same inverse proportion is there, x and y. In front of x we have x1 and x2, and in front of y we have y1 and y2. So inverse proportion is there. It means x1 into y1 will compare with x2 into y2. एक्स वन इज़ टू, वाई वन इज़ थ्री, एक्स टू एज इट इज़, वाई टू इज़ वन. दिस मल्टीप्लीकेटिव वन विल गो अपोजिट साइड, ओके, बट नथिंग विल चेंज. टू थ्री आर सिक्स, सिक्स एज इट इज़. इट मीन्स सिक्स पर्सन इज रिक्वायर्स वैन द नंबर ऑफ डेज वैन वी वॉन्ट टू फिनिश अवर वर्क इन वन डे. ओके, लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज एज चैप्टर ऑल्सो, क्वेश्चन नंबर 11, विच इज अ स्कूल हैज 8 पीरियड्स इन डे ईच ऑफ 45 मिनट ड्यूरेशन. वैन 8 पीरियड इज देयर इन द स्कूल ऑन दैट टाइम वन पीरियड ड्यूरेशन इज 45 मिनट. हाउ लॉन्ग वुड ईच पीरियड बी इफ द स्कूल हैज 9 पीरियड्स अ डे. ओके, आउट ऑफ 8 विल इंक्रीज विद 1 एंड बिकम 9 पीरियड, अज्यूमिंग द नंबर ऑफ स्कूल आवर्स टू बी द सेम. ओके, इट मीन्स 5 आवर्स इफ स्कूल इज गोइंग ऑन दैट टाइम. आउट ऑफ दिस 5 आवर 8 पीरियड इज देयर एंड आउट ऑफ दिस 5 आवर्स 9 पीरियड इज द देयर. ओके, नथिंग विल बी चेंज्ड इन टू द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द स्कूल. 5 आवर्स विल बी सेम टू सेम. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. वेन 8 पीरियड इज देयर ऑन दैट टाइम ईच पीरियड विल बी 45 मिनट. नाउ 9 पीरियड इज देयर, वी वॉन्ट टू टेक द ईच पीरियड ड्यूरेशन. फॉर दैट वी विल ड्रॉ द टेबल. हेयर वी हैव पीरियड्स एंड हेयर वी हैव ड्यूरेशन. वेन 8 पीरियड इज देयर ऑन दैट टाइम ड्यूरेशन इज 45. बट नाउ वी हैव 9 पीरियड एंड वी वॉन्ट टू टेक ईच पीरियड ड्यूरेशन इन मिनट. ओके, सो एक्स इज फॉर द पीरियड्स एंड वाई फॉर द ड्यूरेशन. सो इन फ्रंट ऑफ एक्स वी हैव एक्स वन एंड एक्स टू एंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ वाई वी हैव वाई वन एंड वाई टू. इनवर्स प्रोपोर्शन इज देयर. वी आर इंक्रीजिंग द पीरियड सो दैट द नंबर ऑफ सो दैट द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ द पीरियड विल डिक्रीज. Because out of this 5 hour, out of the same duration, the period is increased by 1. It means duration will be going to be less. Okay? So, inverse proportion is there. That's why we will compare with x1 into y1 is equal to x2 into y2. x1 is 8, y1 is 45. Equal, x2 is 9 and y2 as it is. This multiplicative 9 will go opposite side in the division. 9-1 is 9 and 9-5s are 45. 5 is there and 5-8s are 40 minutes of Y2 because Y2 is in the minute. It means when the number of period is 9, on that time the duration of each period is 40 minutes. So here we completed our exercise with chapter number 13 in direct and inverse proportion.